Welcome to lecture number 5, Convection. Myself, P.S. Sovule, from Department of Mechanical Engineering, SIT COE, Yatra. So many times we are using in day-to-day life convection. For example, by seeing this picture, you may have remembered your childhood in which you are used to pour the tea in a saucer, because at that age it is hard to take a sip from cup. So why we used to pour tea in that saucer? Yes, because it cools faster as compared with cup. And why it cools faster? Because the more surface area of that tea is exposed to air. And what we are doing while taking a sip? Yes, it is. We blow air while taking a sip. Now that ultimately means there is nothing but the natural convection when more surface area is exposed to air. And when we blow air while taking a sip, that is nothing but the forced convection. I think, are you getting what I want to say? Now, let's take a look of what happens if I want to boil some water. When the heat applied at the bottom of that utensil, the hot water molecules, which is having less dense, that water rises to the top, and the cool water becomes more dense and it will come at the bottom. We called it as convection current. But diagrammatically you can see the red line indicates the hot water molecules which come at the top, and blue line indicates the cool water which comes at the down. By this means we can define the convection in this way. It is the transfer of heat from one place to the another by movement of fluid. Convection is usually the dominant form of heat transfer in liquids and gases. Now here, the movement of molecules or movement of fluid is most important phenomenon. The transit or transfer of heat from one place to the another place by movement of fluid. The fluid particle have to move from one place to the another to transfer heat. The rate equation for convective heat transfer between a surface and an adjacent fluid is prescribed by Newton's law of cooling. So let's see what's Newton's law of cooling. Suppose this is the surface which is at temperature TS, and we force, or there is maybe some fluid flow above of that surface which is at temperature TF. Now, if the surface temperature is greater than the fluid flow temperature, that means TS is greater than TF, then in that case, we can determine heat flow Q from surface to the fluid flow by this formula. In this, Q is nothing but the rate of heat transfer. A is the area exposed to heat transfer. As I mentioned, TS is the surface temperature and TF is the fluid temperature. Now H means what? H is the coefficient of convective heat transfer. In previous lecture, we have find out, or we are able to understand what is the thermal conductivity, and in this lecture, now the next concept is of coefficient of convective heat transfer. by rearranging the above term, we can say that H is equal to Q upon A into bracket TS, surface temperature, minus fluid temperature. Sometimes we call it as film heat transfer coefficient also. So can you guess what is the unit of this one? Yes, absolutely. Q, which is at watt per meter square degree Celsius, means coefficient of convective heat transfer, the unit of this is watt per meter square degree Celsius or watt per meter square Kelvin. Both are the same. Now take one example. A hot plate of 1 meter into 1.5 meter is maintained at 300 degree Celsius. That means the surface temperature, they have given here surface temperature TS, which is 300 degree Celsius. Air at 20 degree Celsius blows over the plate. That means this 20 degree Celsius is the fluid flow, or you can say here TF. If the convective heat transfer coefficient is 20 watt per meter square degree Celsius, calculate the rate of heat transfer. So after getting this, now Q is equal to HA into bracket TS minus TF. We have to use this formula. Why? Because they have given the convective heat transfer coefficient. Why we are using this formula? Because as per the Newton's law of cooling. Now simply what we have to do, we need to put the values H, which is 20 watt per meter square degree Celsius, A, which is 1 into 1.5, which come it as 1.5 meter square area exposed to the air flow. TS is the surface temperature, which is at 300 degree Celsius, and TF is the fluid temperature, which is at 20 degree Celsius. By this way, we will get the answer 8400 watt, which is nothing but you can say 8.4 kilowatt. Thank you and stay connected for more videos and keep learning.